Hello viewers, welcome to my channel Pharmacypedia. In this video, we are going to learn a very important topic, that is about the tips and tricks to crack GPAT 2021. This is very important video for BPharm students. All the BPharm aspirants, those who wish to take the admissions in for the master's program, need to crack GPAT examination. The GPAT examination 2021. Here in this video, I will be sharing few tips and few tricks which will help you to crack the GPAT 2021. So let us start. My dear students, there is not a single way defined to crack the GPAT 2021. It has to be required. What is required is the consistent efforts, hard work, determination to move ahead in your life. So for gaining these objectives, one must be clear to work hard, plan the study, and with consistent effort, you will definitely achieve your goal. So to get started, we have to focus on few things. We need to prioritize few chapters in each subject. We need to learn, we need to understand, and we need to plan and devise a method whereby we can have a planned study which will actually help you to crack the exams. So when we talk about the GPAT preparations, it can be done by using different techniques to study while solving the previous year's examination question papers and mock papers. Dear aspirants, you are about to clear a GPAT examinations, which is very tough in present situations. The level of the examination is going up year by year. What I am observing from the past few years is that there is a certain change in the trend which you should keep in your mind. You should plan your study in a way to focus few things in more way by devoting more time, and also to understand and clear your concepts in few topics. So we will be in this video, I'm going to share few tips and few tricks which will actually help you to crack the examinations. First of all, before initiating the studies, aspirant should go through with the GPAT exam question paper, the paper pattern, to prepare well for the exams. 125 questions would be asked each year and the paper would be for 3 hours. So you have to understand and go through the syllabus of the GPAT exam question papers. Then you have to focus on all the important chapters which are covered in pharmacology. What I have been observing from the past few years is that almost about 25 to 30% questions are being asked from this section. The pharmacology part is very easy if you study it thoroughly, if you try to understand it, and if you keep it on revising, and if you plan it in a proper way, this is going to definitely help you out. So while preparing for the exam, while devising the method, you have to learn the pharmacology in a way that you will never forget it. You have to learn the classification in a way that you will never forget it. There is a particular pattern which I will be sharing further in my videos as well. What I have been observing from past few years is that in the GPAT examination question paper, almost around 4 to 5 numerical questions are being asked every year. Maybe it can be related to your dose calculations or from your biopharmaceutics part, but 4 or 5 numerical questions are being asked, and each year the level is actually increasing. So one has to be thoroughly keep on practicing these numerical questions. Also, it has been observed that when we talk about the chemistry, few questions from organic and physical chemistry are based on the 10 plus 12 level. So the basic concepts have to be made clear, and so that you can answer these questions very well. So while studying the chemistry, make sure that you are clear with your basics. Also, when we talk about the GPAT exam pattern and the syllabus, these are the things one must take care of while preparing for the exams. So aspirants should know the GPAT syllabus very clearly, and they should clearly understand the exam pattern. One thing to note here is that it is not important to answer every question. Since it is an online test, computer-based test, which has around 125 objective questions. The duration of the exam is 3 hours, and each correct answer will be awarded with a +4 marks, and a penalty of 1 marks is charged for the wrong answer. So it is pertinent to note here that when you are sure about the correctness of the answer, then only answer the question. It is not important to attempt the complete paper, but you should be sure and pretty sure answer should be marked because you have a negative marking over here. So the exam has questions which are based on the topics which are covered in the BPharm level. Now the syllabus has been uniform for all the BPharm courses everywhere in India. The syllabus has been revised and the syllabus implemented has been common in every university. So the paper pattern and the paper syllabus is well known. In case you have any doubt, I will be sharing the source of the paper pattern and syllabus in the description box below. Applicant should mainly focus on the chapters from five important subjects. They are pharmaceutics, pharmacology, pharmaceutical chemistry, pharmaceutical analysis, and pharmaceutical chemistry. So these subjects basically define the overall paper. Almost 25 to 30 questions are being asked every year from the pharmacology. The pharmacology again is very important. And even the questions have been divided and segregated in a way that if you plan your study properly, definitely it is going to help you. So let us start to understand the key features and the key concepts to be made clear while devising your study plan for the preparation of GPAT 2021. So I will be taking it subject wise. So when we talk about the pharmaceutics, this is the main subject. So one must be clear about the basic dosage forms A to Z about the all the dosage forms like tablets, capsules, emulsions, suspensions, etc. I cannot provide you each and every fine details over in this video, but definitely I will be sharing few topics, few tricks that will actually help you in devising your mind and focusing on these key aspects, because this is out of my experience of the past few, which I am regularly seeing, which I am regularly seeing through the various past year question papers. So one must actually observe the past year question papers, previous year question papers, and also practice them regularly to keep themselves up to date. So I have been seeing that few numerical questions are always asked from pharmaceutics, like it may be related to dose calculations or like even from the some biopharmaceutics parts, stability parts. Individuals should focus on the following topics: pharmaceutical jurisprudence, against Drug and Cosmetic Act is very important. One must be clear about all the details over there. Then apart from that, the few questions like surface and interfacial phenomena are very important. Rheology again is very important. From this topic also many questions are being asked upon. And again, two subjects which are very important, and nowadays many questions are being asked from the subjects like kinetics and drug stability part. Biopharmaceutics and pharmacokinetics, a subject is very important from GPAT point of view. So while studying this subject, one, you must be clear about all the compartment modeling, all the different types of the parameters, even the equations you have to take care of. Then the book which is recommended by the GPAT is for the preparation of pharmaceutics is Lachman. So Lachman is the Bible for the pharmaceutics. So while you study these important topics from the Lachman, keep on revising, keep on practicing the past year practice question papers. Then the next subject is pharmacognosy. Although pharmacognosy is a very theoretical subject, you need to make the notes, you need to keep on revising the key terms continuously so that it remains in your mind. Now few I have been observing from past few years, many questions are being asked about the Sena, morphine and Vinca. So while you are studying for emphasize on these drugs, and also the past year question paper gives you idea about that many questions are being asked about from these topics like glycosides, alkaloids, volatile oils, resins, tannins, carbohydrates, tissue culture and herbal drugs. I don't say that questions will not, but definitely the past trends give you an idea to which extent you should focus on these parts. They are very important from GPAT examination point of view. Now the book recommended for pharmacognosy is C.K. Cocato. Again, this is a very Bible book for pharmacognosy, and how can we forget the Treason Evans? This is very important. They both have to be referred while preparing for the pharmacognosy details. Now let us move to the pharmacology. As I have told earlier, the pharmacology part is becomes very easy if you keep on studying in a proper way. If you learn to classify, the classification of drugs is very important. If you classify and classification, and along with that, the mechanism of action and side effects of the drugs are always asked about. In many questions, the mechanisms, drug interactions, effects of the drug, side effects of the drugs are being asked commonly. So you have to memorize the classification lessons in a simplified way. Moreover, from these following topics also questions are being asked in last few years. So you should always focus on this area like oncology, specifically for the treatment of chemotherapy and other technologies. Also, it has been observed that subjects like neuropharmacology and rare disease questions are also being asked from past few years. You should also focus on the cardiovascular and blood products. This is from my experience from the past few years question papers that many questions have been asked from the cardiovascular and blood products area, neuropharmacology and rare disease disorders, oncology part. Now, the standard book which is being recommended to be referred for pharmacology is K.D. Tripathi. Again, this is the Bible for pharmacology. Next, let us try to understand the key features of the pharmaceutical analysis. See, practicing the solving and numerical questions in pharmaceutical analysis is very important. Keep on memorizing the formulas and keep them in your mind. The important topics as far as pharmaceutical analysis is concerned are like UV, IR and NMR, mass spectroscopy, chromatography, polarography and polarimetry, flame photometer, conductometry, amperometry and potentiometry. So while you are studying these topics in your class, please focus on them. Please try to actually understand the concept, because most of the questions are asked from them. They are very important from GPAT point of view. And also the recommended book for the GPAT preparation for analysis is Spectroscopy and Titration by Chatwal and Chromatography by Remington. So we make sure that you refer these books, because these are the Bible for understanding the pharmaceutical analysis. Now let us try to understand what to focus on pharmaceutical chemistry. When we talk about the chemistry part, one must be very clear and also have to take the base concepts clear from your 10 plus 12 chemistry also. Now applicants should focus on organic chemistry in this section. They should study about the electrophilic, nucleophilic reactions and intermediate reactions. The important topics which have been asked many times in the past few years is about the SAR of steroids, nomenclature and chemical moiety of the medicinal drugs. The recommended books for the pharmaceutical chemistry is again Morrison Boyd and Medicinal Chemistry by S.N. Pandey. So you must refer these. Aspirants, this is not the area, but you should always focus on these areas, because past trends show that many questions have been asked from these areas. Now general preparation tips is that spectroscopy per year 6 to 8 questions are being asked upon. So it is my suggestion to all of you that aspirants should focus on the 6 to 8 questions which may be based on the mass spectrometry, UV and NMR spectroscopy. Students should read these chapters very well. Also, please make separate notes for the medication classification and medication schedules. For the jurisprudence, these schedules are very important. Generally, 3 to 4 questions are also asked on the herbal medicines. So it is my sincere request to all of you, whenever you try to understand the pharmacology part, make clear yourself about the classification in a clear and simplified ways. Also, try to memorize all the schedules pertaining to drugs and cosmetic acts. When we talk about the herbal medicines, always 3 to 4 questions are being asked on that. Now the questions are asked every year to go to the chapter on the herbal and indigenous or traditional medicines. Now it has been observed that the frequency of numerical problems in the GPAT is increasing year by year. Individuals should try this problem to get good marks in the GPAT 2021. Now the questions pertaining to the numerical problems are generally based on doses or other statistical, biopharmaceutical and freezing point, pattern of charges, body weight, etc. So like periodic dose calculations and others, the questions may be asked from different areas. Now it is also being a sincere request from all the applicants that they should regularly solve all the mock papers and the previous year examination question paper, because this will actually help them to understand the pattern of GPAT 2021 in a better way. So till GPAT 2020, you should solve the last 10 years question papers and also try to understand and make clear concepts. Also, you should focus areas through old question papers for other subjects, like other subjects which are being not discussed over here, to understand the key points which are collected from the reference book. Also try to make sure that you are always referring to the standard books. If you don't have access, I have the access of few books which I can share with you all, the details of which you can see in the discussion box. So I really want all of you to clear the GPAT examination. For that, there is no substitute for the hard work. It is my sincere request to all of you, whatever topics I have tried to mention in the each individual subjects, please focus on that. Please study them in detail. In case of any doubt or query, you are always welcome to revert back. Please try to give your comments in the comment box. Now, this is not related actually to the tips and tricks part, but these are few suggestions. Whenever you go for any competitive examination, you have to keep your mind relaxed and calm. It has been found that people who are performing well before the actual examinations are not able to score to that extent, and unexpected people turn out to be very successful in the examination. This is because there are certain other factors also working on them. So, for example, you have to keep your mind relaxed and calm while giving the examination, and don't be overconfident. Try to study while making a beautiful plan and try to execute that plan. One must have to be very flexible. Don't be over enthusiastic and visualize your preparation in a proper way. You should keep on practicing on the question paper. Test your knowledge areas. Try to focus on your weaknesses and try to work upon your weaknesses. Also, please solve the last year question papers, last 10 years question paper, practice them very well, revise your preparation, make notes, study hard, remain cool, and also please maintain your temperament, because this is actually going to help you a good score in the GPAT 2021. Thank you so much for watching my video. Please share your comments in the comment box. Also, please like and subscribe to my channel Pharmacypedia for getting further updates. I'm sure this is going to help you. Please provide your support so that I can further provide you another chances and another videos for GPAT related areas. I will be also sharing you question and answers and fast tricks to help you to prepare for your GPAT 2021. So please subscribe to Pharmacypedia. Thank you so much. Stay happy, stay safe.